gets hard and harder and harder. And your family's not here, it's a whole nother game, man. It's the most horrible feeling in the world. You're just alone. I miss them. And I don't do anything for them.
The thing about addiction, you stay up so long on methamphetamine and cocaine, so many months, and you finally break down in your body. You can really fuck you up, and you number one rule is to blame other people for your problems. So, you ever thought about horrible moments in your past life? You ever thought about horrible outcomes that could happen? Or like me bogging in drug addiction? Uncomfortable. But that uncomfortability is a lot of responsibility. Where you're helping a lot more others that are trying to get off addiction. Dozing off, see? Why?
This is where I realized I fell asleep. It's embarrassing. But at the same time, it must be known. Addiction is real, and this is my story. My name is Nate, and here are my problems. Oh boy.
The challenging part about all this is knowing that you lost everything again, and you gotta regain everything back up. Before I throw this one away, I'm going to deal with this because of the fact that I wanted to share how serious it is through drug addiction. Kids, don't do this. I do not condone this. But what I do condone is, well, deal. Here it goes.
Process of my kids and my wife being gone, so I have to keep myself busy. I'm being pressured right now on my rent, so with that pressure, I got my Schwinn, and I gave it to a buddy of mine, John. He's gonna hook it up with a motor, so hopefully I can sell that and get that going. I really need the money to pay my rent. It gets me scared every day. And I help a lot of people. They just basically like calling the cosmos on my taffy. Look how high I was.
That's really helpful.
Oh my God. I'm glad I stopped. Realization. How are you guys? What does there say? We had a hell of a fantastic run
We threw our game in style and got aesthetic in the first place. I mean, man, it was epic. Now, what the fuck happened? When is it that a man every day strives for himself to fight another day? They can say it's his wife, his kids, his family, his loved and cherished things. But when you come to find out that even that happens, then what? What happens from there? Paradise. Every day a man strives. Every day a woman walks. The child cries, embracing the toys, embracing the structures, the feelings of life. Man, it's a bliss moment. I see things differently. I accept things lovingly, but at the same time, destroyed me. Everything we worked for, gone. It's just an apartment. It's just, you know, that type of shit, right? I see. You have no idea what I'm about to say. But I'm gonna say it anyway. We have pushed man to the bosom and the points of this. I'm ready to take my life and I don't give a shit. Take my life with arsenic drink, pistol to the head, boom. Whatever it needs to be done, because I'm not afraid. Slice to the skin, cut to the throat. As we all know, in the physical life, that's how society goes. They say self-suicide is the wrong thing to do, but I say this, every day we wake up, we have the tendency to eat it like food. Self-suicide tendencies, which we bash ourselves, we bash others, and we feed off of the drains and the blood of our brothers, right? Even their own wife, sister, cousins, lovers, friends, all of the above, just ready to get it in. Embracing the moments, the power and pleasure of play. Because people love to have those puppeteers come in the way. I have come to the conclusion that no matter what you do, silence. We must come to a conclusion of never breaking apart. No matter what obstacle comes afar. You see, with the wake of existence, you don't understand how rhythms and flows and movements. Talk about equality in one. I gave it my best, but it's just begun. Be hell of a war, be hell of a wake. But it's up to you, sir. It's lying and just getting baked. I am the one that's called Nate. That created gods of aesthetics. They snap their flips. The gods are always calling. Is it storming? Is it falling? I mean, what the fuck? It's crawling. As long as it moves, as long as it stays, no matter what, it's here to play an expression. Now I never knew this, that this guy has sucked by who cares. Life is what it is, teardrops are what it be, cause we all know in reality. Just got a mental ward. Feel a lot better. I was there for 5 days. So I'm crazy. Gonna be waiting for my buddy Rudy to come pick me up. Homeless now. It's okay. I take it for what it is. I'll pick up some money right now. Hopefully I can get me a place or a car. Hopefully me and my wife can get back with each other. I tried to kill myself. I took a lot of pills with Bacardi. I died twice. They had to revive me twice. Life's precious. Don't ever forget that. I learned lesson to this, which is we can make it through this no matter what, because no why, because we have no fucking choice. We're gonna be Rocky Balboas and fight another day. Die twice. Don't do that, you guys. My crazy fucking mind, mental ward. Hello, McFly. It's crazy. Coming back outside and coming from there, it just... just makes you appreciate a lot of shit.
Future, she can come back. Denise, if you're watching this, I still love you, and I'm always here. The experience that I had for the 11 minutes of death, I seen brightest light. Brighter than the sun. I seen people. Hundreds of people were there. I was trying to go to it and some magnetic pole would pull me back to my body. It wouldn't allow me to leave. I have to say that there is an afterlife. And wherever that afterlife is, makes you feel so fucking complete. Not like how you are now. Not like how you are with depression. That's for me, you know what I mean? High anxiety. There's there's hope in the afterlife. Complete hope of sincere compassion and love beyond means. I don't ever want to experience that again until I'm ready. I know what to do. I gotta get myself up, dust myself off the dust, and do what the fuck I gotta do. Gotta get. Myself. My bad. Together, like that. You know, I just chopped them.